Hey guys, we're continuing our series on giving you tools on how to get out there and actually start sharing your faith with some tools that will help you be articulate what you're trying to do. Now, in the past few videos, we've been seeing different tools you can use to actually share the gospel, right? We saw the sacrifice story, we saw the bridge method, we saw three circles, so many great methods. But you might say, how do we get there in a conversation, right? How does that naturally arise without feeling forced, getting someone all protective, right? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. How to get conversations headed in that direction in a way that feels natural and comfortable for the other person. So excited about this. Let's get in and start talking about four. Now, F.O.U.R is a tool that I've been using for some time now, and it makes these conversations so much more fun, so much more positive and comfortable. And yeah, it just makes it a great experience on both sides. Now, F.O.U.R deals with four topics that you're going to run through to start getting to deeper, more spiritual conversation. And that is family, occupation, upbringing, and religion. F.O.U.R, family, occupation, upbringing, and religion. Now, let's say you're sitting next to someone on a plane ride, or you're meeting up with a new friend. You can ask them these easy questions that are, they make sense, right? Ask them, oh, what's your family like? Do you have any siblings? Where do your parents live? Ask them about their family. Next, occupation. What do your parents do? Or what do you do, depending on their age? What do you do for a living? What's your career? Or what are you aspiring towards? Then you can ask them about their upbringing, right? What got you to that? Or what's it like having a parent that does that? Or you want to go towards this? What got you to that? What's your upbringing like? Are your parents very religious? Did you grow up in a religious context? Then get them talking about that, and that opens the conversation to religion, to spiritual conversation. Like, oh, that's interesting. Have you ever thought about such and such? So that's in short, four: family, occupation, upbringing, and religion. Now, what does that actually look like in conversation? Well, it might look something like this. Hey, Joe. Hey, Ash, how's it going? Dude, this is a pretty good game, isn't it? What do you think's gonna happen? Bruh, this is such a good game. The Angels might even pull in and win this one. Dude, I don't know. I think they might get it. Yeah, bruh, I've always loved baseball. Not really, to be clear, disclaimer. Yeah, I used to grow up with my family. We'd watch it on TV. My grandpa loved it. Such a fun sport, just to watch with my family. Good memories. Dude, same. My dad loves baseball, so I grew up playing catch with them, and yeah, we'd watch it together. That's so much fun. Do you have any siblings? Would they do it with you too, or what's your family like? Yeah, dude, I have a younger brother and a younger sister, but I'm the oldest. So yeah, it's just five of us at home, both parents, and then three of us kids. So yeah, I love it. Dude, yeah, I love my family. What's your dad do? My dad's actually a plumber. Yeah, guess he got into that sometime back, but it's actually pretty interesting seeing what he gets to do. That's cool. I have a friend who's a plumber. It's very disciplined. Like, I feel like it's hard work. So, did that ever kind of play out in your household? Like, is he that kind of character that's like a go-getter, very hardworking? What was that like for you growing up in that kind of household? Yeah, dude. Yeah, definitely. He's that hardworking, disciplined type. So that definitely kind of played off a lot in raising us. Definitely had all that discipline in there. So, hey, it was hard, but I guess made me who I am, so that's pretty good. Yeah, dude, that's awesome. Is he kind of like the religious discipline type, or was that like a religious context, or what was that like in your household? Yeah, my dad's actually Muslim, so definitely I feel like maybe his hardworking integrity kind of comes from his religious beliefs. So I kind of grew up in that kind of context, as a Muslim. So yeah, that's kind of my religious context. Dude, that's so cool. I've been learning a little bit about different world religions in my class. I'm an anthropology major, so dude, I've always loved just hearing about religions. What is kind of like the core tenet, or what's the belief system in Islam? Can you explain that to me? Like, I just love learning this stuff. Yeah, man. Kind of goes something like this. And that makes the way for an epic conversation. Lots of learning on both sides. You know what happens in my experience after walking through their beliefs? They'll then turn and ask, how about you, bro? At which point you can walk through your story. Now, I don't suggest jumping right into religion, but kind of do the same way. Family, occupation, upbringing, religion. That's the story of someone's life, right? So like for me, I could say, and this is actually my true story. Yeah, my family, I got four siblings, two brothers and two sisters. My dad and mom actually moved to Spain before I was born. I was born and raised in Spain. He's actually a pastor over there. So that's kind of his occupation. He's a pastor. He teaches English too, so the local people want to learn English. So that's kind of the context I grew up in. Yeah, religious household, Christian. Definitely played a lot into the way he raised us. Like you said, integrity, hardworking, in Christianity, like he raised us to follow Jesus. So yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. That's my religious background. As a Christian, I believe that Jesus, he's God, right? I believe that we are created to be in relationship with him, but that we made a mistake, and that's what resulted in all the brokenness around us. So there's a divide between us and God because of our mistakes, our sin, and there needs to be a payment for that. And this is where I think Christianity goes apart from other religions, maybe like Islam. We have to do certain things to earn your favor with God. Is that accurate? Yeah, in Christianity, we believe that there's nothing we could ever do to earn favor with God. We believe that we need grace, and that's where Jesus comes in, actually. He comes to die for us, to pay the price for our sin, to cover this divide between us and God. We see that we could never do that, but because he is God, he's the only one who can pay the price, the sins, the penalties against an infinite God. Only an infinite God can pay that price because it's infinite. So anyway, that's what we believe Jesus did. He came, he lived a perfect life. He performed miracles. He forgave sins. He claimed to be God. He predicted his own death. And then he ultimately died on a cross. And then 3 days later, rose from the grave and appeared to over 300 witnesses. So, what does that mean? For me, that means that Jesus is God. What he claimed is true. And also, what he offers is true, which he said that. If we follow him, right? If we believe in him, confess what he did, then we're saved. And what that means is we have life with him. In John 17:3, it says, "This is eternal life, that they know you, God, and Jesus Christ whom you've sent." So the life of a Christian, it's not just like doing rituals, trying to appease God, but it's really fundamentally belief in a relationship that we get to have with God because of what Jesus has done for us. Because of what he's done, he brings us into right relationship with God, which is the purpose of it from the beginning, what we see in Genesis, the beginning of our book. So yeah, that's kind of Christianity, and I don't know, it's really changed my life. Like, I believe it's actually true that I actually have a relationship with God, and yeah, it's brought me through some really hard times, and yeah, that's Christianity. Is that something you've heard about? Would you like to hear more about that? And guys, that opens the door for discipleship. Someone can say, "Nah, that's cool, bro, but I'm good. Thanks for explaining that to me." And you know what? Some people do say, "Yeah, actually, that sounds pretty interesting. I'd love to hear more about that." To which I would say, don't force it all on them at that point, but definitely plan a time like, "Hey, let's get a time clarified. What are you doing on Tuesday? You know, let's meet for coffee." Get a specific time plan to actually go and do that. But don't force it all on them in one day. Let them have time to kind of think through what you've said instead of overloading them with it all in one instance. You see, that was an easy conversation with an easy way in. Like, some people are gonna be more closed off. You're not gonna be able to get all the way through there in every conversation. That's just the fact of the matter. But for most people that are open and most people are interested in spiritual stuff, they're gonna welcome that conversation so long as it's not forced on them. And that's why I recommend running through family, occupation, upbringing, and religion, both when asking them, but also when sharing your own story. Don't jump straight into religion. Go through your story, right? There's so much more to you than just your beliefs, even though those beliefs have strong reasons that they're true. There's so much more. Like, tell your life story. Tell them about your family. Tell them about your parents' occupation, your occupation. Tell them about your upbringing, what brought you to this point, and then give the way into Christianity because that has changed our lives. And that's just an easy conversation. Like, even if you're not a Christian and you're watching this, like, that's just an easy way to talk about these things that really matter, right? Yeah, they matter to us, obviously, they matter to you. But they matter. Like, what we believe matters, whether it's true or false. So we should talk to people with different views. So even if you're not a Christian, you're watching this, like, let's have these conversations. Family, occupation, upbringing, religion. We should feel comfortable to have these conversations that really matter. And this is an avenue that we can go straight into that. So I hope this tool really helps you. It's helped me get to these really good conversations. You can see it makes for really just a safe, comfortable, and positive conversation, even if it doesn't get all the way to the end. So I hope you find this really helpful. Four, definitely try putting it to practice. If you do it, let me know in the comment section below how it went. And yeah, let's just see how you do. Get out there and start sharing what you believe in the context of relationships. So thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.